Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to this cool special episode of Algae Corner on microscope creatures. So what we want to do today is give you a little snapshot of a bunch of different creatures, what's common in your lake or pond. Now, most of the time I'm looking for algae under the microscope, but it's important to note all these different types of cool creatures that we see in these lake, pond, and water samples out there. Now, I got to warn you, some of them look a little prickly and mean, but most are, again, very safe for people, very natural components of a pond system. And many of these creatures actually filter out algae, so they use algae as a food source. They can filter out hundreds of thousands of cells every day and use them to grow. So some neat creatures we're going to cover today. Sit back, enjoy, hope you learn a lot, but we're going to see some pretty cool microscope creatures for you today. All right, first up is a group called the ostracods. Now, the ostracods, that's a class of classification, but they're actually little crustaceans too. That's a subphylum. They're called shrimp seeds. Now, they have this cool little sort of bivalve shell, and you can see their legs coming out. They're around 1 millimeter in size. They vary from about 0.2 millimeters to 30 millimeters. Over 8,000 species of these little guys. Pretty cosmopolitan out there. And usually you see them crawling around. So they're eating bacteria and detritus and algae that's growing on plants and other filamentous algal mats. So you see them crawling around, eating these things off of those aquatic growths. So the common types I see, the species I see, are Heterocyprus and Cypridopsis. So that's the ostracods. All right, next up is another cladostren. So this is an order of classification, and they're also crustaceans. So again, tiny little animals, little arthropod animals. There's about 700 species out there. They're up to 5 millimeters in length. The common species I see are Daphnia, they're real common in water resources, and Bosmina. But they're sort of flattened. They have this see-through carapace, if you will, and they bounce around in the water column. They filter out algae and bacteria, detritus, about anything they can fit in their gullet. So these cladostrens, very cool group of invertebrates as well, and very common out there. All right, next up, I got one more group of crustaceans to cover with you. These are the copepods. Again, very, very common out there. Over 20,000 species have been described. Very small, about 1 to 2 millimeters in length. A lot of them have these big antennae that come out, and again, they filter, feed out algae, plankton, and bacteria, a lot of things in the water column that they can, again, get in their filtering apparatus down their gullet. So they grow in almost every habitat throughout the world, so very common in water resources. They started as this little stage called this nauplius, little stage, and then they molt. They can molt many times, 5-6 times, and grow into these different cool-looking adults. So there's three main types of copepods: the calanoids, the harpacticoids, and the cyclopoids are the ones I normally see. So we got some cool pictures of those to show you on those types of copepods and water resources. All right, next up, very neat group. These are one of my favorite. They're called the rotifers. So very small animal, actually the world's tiniest animal, and they're called wheel animals. So that they have these rotors that move around. They create this current and just bring things into their mouth, algae and bacteria. Here's a couple, you know, cool videos of them, and you can see those rotors just going a mile a minute and creating that vortex of water coming in. So they'll eat, again, algae and detritus, bacteria, anything that can fit in their mouths. They're very small, 0.1 to 0.5 millimeters in length, the smallest animals on Earth, these multi-celled, tiny little aquatic animals that swim around, but again, very common in water resources. There's around 2,000 species. We're going to change it up a little bit. Next up are paramecium. Now, these are little protists. So protists aren't plants, animals, or fungi. They're sort of this weird group. They, you know, lump in all together by themselves. But these little paramecium, they're unicellular ciliates. They have these short hairs, and they sort of swim around in water bodies. They have this amoeboid movement. They're 50 to 300 micrometers in size, and they feed on other microscopic creatures. They can engulf things like bacteria into their gullet, and certainly some algae as well. So they're common in most aquatic habitats, but pretty neat-looking little ciliated protozoa, these paramecium. All right, another one here. This one, I gotta warn you, this one's a little creepy, but certainly one of my favorites. These are water mites. Ooh, I know it sounds a little creepy, but again, they're tiny little arthropod animals, and they're in the same class as spiders, so arachnida. So they got these eight legs and these big chelicera out there, and they're actually piercer predators. So they feed on insect larvae and small crustaceans and anything they can sort of grab and pierce into. So they're pretty creepy looking. Most of the time they leave people alone, but they are, again, common components in a lot of systems, these little arthropod water mites. They're about 2 to 3 millimeters in length. They're pretty interesting if you see them under the microscope. Next up, another very cool group here, the euglenoids. Now, these are classified as algae. I had to throw in an algae one at the end. So the euglenoids, they include Euglena and Trichelomonas and Phacus, very, very neat creatures. And most of these are photosynthetic. So they do harness energy from the sun. A lot of them look green or darker in color. They have these different pigments. But some of these euglenoids are indeed mixotrophic or heterotrophic. So they can just absorb other organic compounds from the water or use bacteria or eat other algae. So they sort of span a lot of different modes of feeding, but the euglenophytes are classified in that big group of the algae. Little single-celled, they got this big flagella to help them move around, a little rudder some of them have as a tail, and they have this neat eye spot so they can actually detect different wavelengths of light and see in the water and swim around. So this is a protist, but classified in that big group of algae. Thank you for tuning in to this very special episode of Algae Corner on microscope creatures. So hopefully you saw some cool stuff, maybe not too scary, but hopefully you saw some neat stuff under the microscope and learned a lot about this amazing world under the microscope that's out there in your pond. Very, neat components of an aquatic system. We just covered, just a handful of those common species out there, but there's all sorts of other ones. I mean, here's some pictures of roundworms and flatworms and chironomids and so forth, but again, we just want to give you a highlight of some of those very common ones that we see in water samples, very natural components of your pond system. So, as always, let us know if you have any questions, and thank you for tuning in to this special episode, and we'll catch you next time on the Algae Corner. We'll be right back.